So you will get the choice to go first or last with starting the game. I know some people have a strategy where going last benefits them better, so that's why I like to give you
No,
the
that's dumb.
option.
That's dumb. Always go first.
Well, some people, like to play land tax or whatever, go fetch them an extra land or something. And
Yeah, no
also,
worries.
you get to choose the music we listen to while we play the game. So you
Oh,
won't get to
very
hear it, but the
excellent.
people on the stream will get to hear
Oh, okay.
So.
Okay, you know what's a spicy great album. Let's listen to The Sacred Talisman by Nocturnal Rites.
Dude, hell yeah. I was just thinking of them
Yeah.
earlier when you and I were talking about being on Napalm and AFM Records, because Nocturnal Rites is another band on AFM Records.
Dude, that is the band that I have said, I don't care what anybody says, if that band comes to Toronto, I would spend like $100 to see that band. I don't give a shit.
Shadowlands actually one of my favorite albums of all time, man.
I fucking
When I
love
heard
it.
that
It's so
album,
good.
like power metal on a seven string, fuck yeah, dude. I mean, I know they're not the first, but they do it so well. So let's get some Nocturnal Rites going. Okay. And then one more thing. Not a lot of viewers today, so you might be lucky, but something I do on the stream is I have what's called an enchantment dice lock. So what that means is
Okay.
any viewer can donate to the stream, and at instant speed, I roll dice. And whatever it lands on, an enchantment will appear in the game that everyone gets access to. It can either be good for you or bad for you, but it does create chaos.
Okay, so it's like a little bit of a plane chase just added into
Yeah,
it.
it's essentially plane chase that the chat can essentially make happen if they so feel like. And it's enchantments that exist within the game. So it's not like plane chase cards, but essentially, yes, it's like plane chase, but give me money. Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so music's on.
Alrighty, I guess I will pick my
Yeah,
commander.
so.
What is our power level that we're doing? We're playing some high powered stuff.
Oh yeah, I think we're saying one of your
Yeah.
eights would probably be fine. I think I usually sit around a
Oh.
seven. So I think your four and five would be a little too weak, so if I gotta go against an eight, that's fine.
Alrighty,
All
I will
right,
play
I'm gonna
Everett.
randomize the order. You will go first, but this will determine if myself or Jonathan goes after you. So I'll do it twice. Okay. So Jonathan, you're last. Matt or
Yep.
Damien aren't here, so it had to be you.
Understandable.
Alrighty, let's get this mouse out of the way.
By the way, I love that play, Matt Jimmy.
Oh yeah, thank you. Yeah, I figured it'd be nice to our throwback of when we met.
Right?
Yeah, no, this was actually the first GP that I ever played in. I played in the modern GP, and then I tried to get in through draft. This was right before I met you, actually, because I think I met you in August of that year.
I'm gonna believe you. I don't remember, but
Yeah, I have this weird thing with dates. I'm pretty good with remembering like times of certain things. I don't know why.
that's
All of our
awesome.
brains work differently.
Right. Oh, yeah, sorry. Why don't we say who we're playing for everybody? So, who are you playing, Jimmy?
I am going to be playing Edric, Spymaster of Trest. This is a turns deck that I essentially want to draw as many cards as possible, and I also use Edric's ability as a political tool for my opponents. If my opponents need to draw cards, it is beneficial for them to attack each other instead of me, because if the attack goes through, they draw cards.
I like it. I read that
Yeah.
earlier, and I'm just now realizing it's any creature deals damage to an opponent, not just yours.
Yep.
So, very nice.
Exactly. Yeah, so sometimes while some people do want to... whoops, dropped a couple cards there. While some people do want to attack me, sometimes they might be mana screwed or other stuff, and it might be, you know what, I'm just going to attack the other guy so I can draw and then see what that gets me.
Nice. All right. Jonathan, who are you playing?
Today I'm coming here with Zephyrus, and it's a reanimation package with Dungeon Crawler shenanigans, and yeah, I'm going to get back big stuff and hit you for lots.
And draw cards because of Jimmy. Great. I see how this is going.
Yeah.
All right. I am playing Vayrin, Voice of Duality. 2/2 has Magecraft. Whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, Vayrin, Voice of Duality gets +1/+1 until end of turn. If you casting or copying an instant or sorcery spell causes a triggered ability of a permanent you control to trigger, that ability triggers an additional time. So that may be my commander, but I actually have a secret commander, which I'm sure everyone playing's already guessed. Most people guess it right away, but Jonathan was one of the guys who actually helped me build this deck, so Jonathan knows what's coming. But yeah, we'll keep it a surprise for everybody else.
Excellent.
Yeah. Yeah, whenever we're ready, you can get this thing going.
Alrighty. Yep. Okay, so if we are good to go, all right, I will draw for turn. I will play an island. I will tap that. I'll play a Siren Storm Tamer. Just give me 1 second.
Oh, that made it worse.
Is that... that made it worse? Okay. Alrighty. I've played on Spell Table before, and if I turn off that top light, sometimes it makes it easier. So there. Okay, maybe that might make it easier. But Siren Storm Tabor is a 1-mana, 1/1 flying creature, where if I sacrifice it, counter target spell or ability that targets myself or a creature that I control.
Gnarly.
Mm. Almost as good as Stormcrow.
Yes, almost.
Okay, I'll draw for turn. Ooh, spicy boys. I'm going to play Steam Vents. I'm going to pay the 2 life to shock it in. Then I'm going to tap for 2. Or I'm sorry, 1. For Faithless Looting, draw 2 cards, then discard 2 cards. It has flashback for 2 and a red. So I'll draw 2 cards. Ooh, Biff! That's a Biff, everybody. So, man, okay, well, gonna discard 2 cards, as I said. So one will be Laboratory Maniac, don't mind him. Shitty. The other's gonna be Jace's Archivist? Jace's Archivist. Yep. However you say that. So, and then I'll sadly pass.
With the best. Right, so I'll draw. And that's basically the best I could draw on. So I'm playing a Godless Shrine tap, then pass.
Okay.
Alrighty. Untap, upkeep. Draw for turn. I'll play a Command Tower. And I will tap that, play a Land of War Elves, and I will swing one at Jason.
Hit me while I'm down. All right, I'll take 1.
Alrighty. And then I will pass turn.
Okay. Draw. God, I don't want to do any of this yet. I'm going to play an island. I'm going to live dangerously. And pay a red for gamble. Search your library for a card. Put that card into your hand. Discard a card at random. And then shuffle your library.
Sure.
Yep. So yep. I'll search for
that. That is good for me.
I'll search a card for a card. But what card? I forgot what it's called. Again, I've only played this deck twice. I know the card I want, just forgot the name of it, so...
I made a bunch of upgrades to my mono green deck, and before I was playing with you guys, I was thinking about all the different lines now that I have, because I added new cards, and I was like, honestly, I haven't studied this deck enough. I'll just play the Simic deck.
Right. Where are you at? Here somewhere.
Yeah. I know the feel about green cards. Like, I just got new cards for my mono green deck, and yeah. It just opens up so much with one card.
Right.
No, it's really good, yeah. I got Ayesha, Voice of the Wild, where I'm like, turning everything into a forest land just really opens up the possibilities for the deck.
Yeah. Ask Jason what he thinks about Akshaya.
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly the deck that I put it in.
All right.
Yeah, he's quite good.
I'm going to shuffle these up, and Jimmy, as the musical guest, choose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6.
I will choose 5.
Woo! It's an island, so I will discard an island. Which is what I tutored for.
May that be the last one you see.
How dare you. Yeah. Pass.
Hands up and draw. So I'm going to play an island, tap 2, 2. Play myself a Blood Artist.
Uh-oh.
He's a 0/1, and whenever he or another creature dies, target player loses 1 life and I gain 1 life. So that goes for all creatures.
Alright.
And that's it. Pass the turn.
Alrighty. Untap. Upkeep. Draw for turn. That is not bad. I will play... I'll play a Reliquary Tower.
That's not bad at all.
I will play my commander, Edric, Spymaster of Trest. And then I will move 2 attacks, and I will swing 2 at Jason. Sorry, but you're the only one that doesn't have any blockers.
Alright. I will take
Alrighty.
2.
And then I will draw 2 cards. And... I have 7 cards in hand, and I will pass a turn.
You also have Reliquary Tower, though.
I do.
I will draw. I will play Riptide Laboratory. Taps for a colorless, or I can pay a 1 and a blue and tap it. Return target wizard you control to its owner's hand. And I'm going to tap for 3 for Intuition. Search the library for 3 cards and reveal them. Target opponent chooses 1. Put that card into your hand and the rest into your graveyard.
Alrighty.
So, I will reveal a Dragon's Approach. And I will reveal a Dragon's Approach. And I will reveal... A Dragon's Approach. Jonathan!
You have cheated, sir.
Ooh, this is a tough choice.
What do you want me to keep?
I'll think... Let's see. You can keep the Dragon's Approach in the middle.
Oh, that one?
Yeah.
That's not the one I want.
I would have picked that. I would have picked the middle one, too.
Yeah. You know this deck has not been played much because the sleeves are still slippery. Alright, keep the one in the middle, discarding the other 2, and pass there.
Alright, I'll untap, and I'll draw. I will play a Swamp for turn. Let's see. I will tap 3 to cast a Chromatic Lantern.
Whoa.
and pass the turn.
See, Jimmy, he is nice and just passes instead of attacking Jason.
Listen, the best thing to do in Magic is draw cards. So that's all I'm going to do.
Fair enough.
All I want to do. Alrighty, so what do I got? Yeah, I did not. So I got untap, upkeep, draw for turn. I will play a Dreamroot Castle, which enters the battlefield tapped unless I control two or more other lands. I will move to attacks. I will attack Jonathan with Edric, and then I will swing Llanowar and Siren at Jason.
I'll take two.
All right. I'll take two, Commander.
Alrighty, I will draw three cards.
This is getting out of control, Jonathan. Just drawing all these cards.
Alrighty, I'm going to play... I'll tap this. I will play a Gruul Lurker, which is a 1-1. It cannot be blocked, and it has Megamorph, but I'm obviously not playing that. And then I will also play... we'll test the same anyways. Tap my command tower, and I will play a Miscloaked Herald, which is a 1-1, and Miscloaked Herald cannot be blocked. And I will pass the turn.
I see the strategy here.
I told you, I just want to draw cards. That's all I want to do.
All right. I will attempt to tap three. Wait, how many cards in your hand, Jimmy?
Eight.
Jonathan?
I have five.
Okay. I will attempt to play Windmill. Each player discards their hand, then draws cards equal to the greatest number of cards a player discarded this way.
No responses.
Okay.
I'm afraid I'm gonna have to make you an offer you can't refuse.
Okay. Let's see, what does that one do? Counter target on creature
spell. It's...
Oh, two treasure tokens. Sweet. I'll take that.
Oh no, he's ramping.
Alright, two treasure tokens. I'll use one of those two treasure tokens for Winds of Change. Each player shuffles the cards from their hand into their library, then draws that many cards.
Why are you doing this to me?
Because it's...
Why? Like, listen. God damn it.
Alright, so shuffle. Any responses?
Hold on. I'm thinking.
Right? Okay.
Hold on. Give me a minute. God damn it. Okay. Okay, I don't care about these ones, but I enjoy these two. So it's like, do I burn one of these just to keep these five like I don't really want? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so what? We just discard and then I'm going to discard and draw seven?
You shuffle it. So each player shuffles the cards from their hand into their library, then draws that many. So you
yeah,
might, you, all might
right.
you might draw
right,
them
I'll
again.
Do it. Yeah, I'll do it. Yeah. All right, I'll be honest. The five cards that I had that I didn't want are all lands. But one of the other ones is a Force of Negation, which I shoved back in. Where
okay,
I was like,
I'm going to respond to this with the last... I think I can do this at instant speed. You need
to hold priority, so that's before that resolves.
Oh.
So like, before you ask us if it resolves, you have to cast it.
Okay, well, can I still... Well... So it's lonely.
Well, what is it?
It's Lonely Sandbar. I want to cycle it. Can I do that?
Cycle your land? Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Okay, so that way I can get the card draw off it before I have to shuffle it. So
worst case, I had a creature, a 1/1 blue creature, and a Force of Negation in my hand, and if it was too bad, I'm like, all right, I'll just go search for those two things and put them in my graveyard.
Right.
And counter it. Alrighty, so cut. Cut the deck, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I will draw. Well, I don't know why I did that, because I'm just going to draw three cards now, so I still would have drawn four cards, so that didn't really... Whatever. I wasted a treasure. See? Fucking up.
Oh, that's way better. Yeah, that actually worked. That really worked out.
Yeah. Yeah,
that kind of worked out.
That was a dumb play on my part. So draw three cards. All right, I'm not mad about that. Okay, then I'll pass the turn.
Yep. Right, I'll untap, draw. Let's see here. Tap for one and cast a soul ring.
Yep.
Let's see here.
See, I got you that soul ring, bro. You're welcome.
Yeah. Let's see. Lines.
Don't forget, Jason, you've got two treasure tokens, I think.
I already used them.
I used them.
Oh, okay.
I used one on Winds of Change, and then one stupidly on the discard when I could have drawn it. Anyways, yeah.
Gotcha.
Okay. So, Jason, I'm going to repay the favor.
Okay.
I'm going to cast a Wishclaw Talisman. Floating one colorless.
All right.
Yeah, that resolves.
What does that do again?
It enters with three counters on it. I can pay one, tap it, remove a counter, tutor for any card, and then I have to give it to an opponent.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
You can only activate it during your turn. Specifically, during your turn, so anytime. Instant speed.
Right. On your turn.
Yeah, so I'm using my Floating Colorless. And give it to you, Jason. And
my I'll man! For a card. All right. I need some creatures off the board is what I need.
Let's see, I have two there.
I like that Expedition Steam Vents you got there.
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's a beautiful proxy.
Excellent.
I was going bankrupt with Magic, dude. I had to turn proxy.
No, I totally get it. Yeah. I traded in my old Modern deck to get a whole bunch of like actual real cards, but I have been thinking of... I found a place where you can get some really good high quality proxies,
right?
And definitely play them too.
Yeah, it's just especially with how much content they're pushing out. It's like, I'm sorry guys, I don't know who you think I am, but I cannot afford this.
All right, get my card. Then we will tap these two. For a merfolk looter. It's a merfolk that loots.
Huh.
Excellent.
Yeah. At land for turn, Dimir Aqueduct, bouncing my swamp to my hand. And pass the turn.
Ready. I will untap. Okay, I'll put Edric here. He's the blocker ones. That's a lot. Makes it a little bit easier. Okay, untap, upkeep, draw for turn. Alrighty. I will play a Hinterland Harbor. It enters the battlefield tapped unless I control a forest or an island. What you do? I will move to attacks. I will swing two unblockable and one in the air at Jonathan, and I will swing two at Jason, and I believe you've already taken two attacks from Edric, so you have 4 commander damage from Edric. And this will be.
I think 6. Jonathan took the last one.
Yeah, I took one, Jonathan. So I have 2.
Okay. Yeah. So, okay. Cool.
Yeah, but I will take 2.
And I will take 3 damage.
Yeah, and then I will draw 3 cards. 1, 2, 3. Okay. I think I'm going to. Let's see. Do I? Yeah, why not? Let's see if we can make this work. For 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I will cast Karn's Temporal Sundering. I will target player takes an extra turn. Return up to 1 target non-land permanent to its owner's hand. And then I exile Karn. And I can only cast this spell if I control a legendary creature. And I control Edric.
Yeah.
And I will target Jonathan Solring.
Alright. You sure you wanna let Jason have his search?
He has a search trigger.
I have the talisman.
Yeah, he has the talisman.
I don't whereabouts is it? On his board?
It's
the Wishclaw talisman. You're right. Yeah. Actually, yeah, sorry. Okay, yeah, absolutely, yeah, I do want to bounce the Wishclaw talisman. Yeah. Yeah, so I guess that goes back to. Yeah, so that goes back to.
He just did that so he gets to use it again.
No, I get it, but even still, it's letting you untap with it is also an issue.
No.
So yeah, I will move to my end step and attempt to take another turn.
You will indeed take another turn.
Alrighty. Untap, upkeep, draw. I will move to attacks. I will do again 3 at Jonathan and 2 at Jason. I'll draw 2, 3, 4 cards. Okay. I will play a Yavimaya Coast for turn. And let's see. Do I have? Yeah. Oh, I'm like one mana short. Okay, I will instead. Alrighty, I'm gonna try to pop off here. For 6 mana, I'm gonna try and play Notorious Throng for its prowl cost. So if I did damage with a rogue this turn, which Edric is. I put X 1/1 black fairy creature tokens with flying into play, where X is the amount of damage dealt this turn. If Notorious Throng's prowl cost was paid, take another turn after this one.
Oh my god.
Jeez.
Yeah, so I did 5 damage, so I'll create 5 1/1 flying tokens.
It's not just the damage the rogue did?
No, it's all the damage that was done this turn.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Where X is the damage that was dealt to your opponents this turn. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
So we got 5 there, and then I guess... Yeah, I played Yavimaya Coast for turn. So I'll move to the end step and try and take another turn.
Yeah. Well, I can just say I'm F6 right now.
Yeah, I don't got anything.
Alrighty. I will untap, upkeep, draw for turn. I will move to attacks. I will send, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll send five at Jonathan and five at Jason.
All right, I'll take five.
I'll take five.
And that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll draw 8 cards.
Jesus.
Alrighty. Alrighty. I'll play tap Reliquary Tower, get a Soul Ring. I will let you know now that if you guys cannot interact, I have 19 cards in hand, and I can take 3 extra turns past this.
Yeah, that's game.
Good game.
Good game. Yeah, well drawn, looted.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No responses.
Short on interaction.
Right.
Alrighty. And that is only the second time I've ever popped off with that. I recently upgraded it. So
nice.
Would you guys consider, was that like an 8-9? Is that within the high power level that you guys are playing? Would you like me to
bring it down? I would say that's stronger than we usually play. At least me. But yeah, I don't know.
It's about 8-9 there.
Yeah. That was, but I don't know because like, I know we definitely do stronger than 4-5, but I also don't think we play that strong.
Okay.
So I don't know if you have anything in between, you know.
Like I said, I have an Edgar Markov Vampires deck where I don't have any fetches or shocks in it, but I mean it's just like vampire bullshit that Edgar does.
Honestly, yeah. I've seen people play not such strong Edgar decks, and they're still like kind of strong.
Yeah. So I've got that, and then I have a Hirobi Death's Wail, which is just kind of like a funny meme deck that I don't really get to play. But because that one was really fast, would you guys like to play again?
Let's do it. Yeah. I'm pretty much good till 6, so an hour and 20 minutes. Yeah.
Okay. Perfect. Yeah. Like I said, so yeah, I've got Edgar Markov and this other, which is a fun one, which is Hirobi. Let me see if I can figure out how cameras work. Hirobi's Death Wail, and it's whenever a creature becomes the target of a spell or ability, destroy that creature.
Ooh.
No.
So like, It does some really fun shenanigans to the table when people realize that like their enchant creature spells are now suddenly removal.
Yeah, I like
Lightning Greaves doesn't work anymore because Lightning Greaves has to target a creature, so Hirobi kills it before the Lightning Greaves attaches.
Yep.
And things like that. So,
if you do that one, I'm definitely not playing this deck because that's a major thing about this deck.
is the Voltron off?
It's not okay, Voltron, but I do. My win con does depend on, hopefully. I don't want to give away my secrets. Come on now.
It's just curiosity, Ophidian's eye type stuff, right?
Yeah. No, but yes. Yeah, it's funny because like I've never had an Izzet deck, and so I told the guys like, "Hey, man, I want to build an Izzet deck," and they built this for me, or they helped me build it. Damien was a big part of it, our buddy Damien. But I'm now realizing like it's everyone fucking knows like its secrets. Like it's like, oh, it's a Niv-Mizzet deck. Like we know exactly what you're doing. So it's sort of like there's no, But it's like, I did pay for it, so damn it, I want to play it.
I will tell you that this deck has my two most expensive cards that I own in it. I have an Imperial Seal in this one, and I have the only duel I've ever had. I've had this card since I was like 12 years old, but it's a Plateau.
Oh, dude, that's amazing. Like,
where's this thing?
That's awesome.
There you go. So yeah, that's it. That's all I got. But I have no fetches and I have no shocks in this deck. So if I get a Plateau, it's just because I drew into it. And I'm in Mardu, so I don't really draw cards.
Right. Man, we played... I don't know if you were on this one, Jonathan. I think you were, but we played a stream... My last one with my musical guest Parker and his buddy came on because we needed a fourth player. And...
Yeah.
Fucking turn one opposition agent. We're all just wonderful. Like, yeah, we're like, cool, all right, off to a good start.
And then the guy like me who's just playing tap lands, I'm like, excellent.
Yeah. You know. It was like a split second of, damn, I'm salty, but it's like, that was kind of impressive to see.
Let's see.
Was like Bayou into Dark Ritual into Opposition Agent into Jeweled Lotus into Commander.
Yeah.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
Yeah, that's right. Like,
that's some dirty shit.
Yeah. I think the whole table went silent. We're just like, okay. And I remember because like, I kept my opening hand because it had two lands, but I had both like, I had three visits, Rampant Growth, and Nature's Lore. So I was like, fuck yeah. And then turn one Opposition Agent. I was like, well, there we go. Yeah. All right, same thing. I'll have you go first, Jimmy. Let me do some... I'm going to do one randomizer this time. And
this changes nothing.
It changed absolutely nothing. Except you're now in the middle. So there you go.
Alrighty. I have lands. I have things. Yeah, this is good. I'll keep. I will use this opportunity to get myself a beer. I will be right back.
Perfect.
Solid choice.
If you have a beer outside the game, you may start the game with it in your hand. Come on, baby. God damn. That's it. I'm never letting you guys build me a deck again. No. Take this hat off. It's getting a little toasty.
Don't forget to reset your life, Jason.
Oh, thank you. Reset. What you got there?
Bone Shaker.
Nice. Oh, we can't hear you all of a sudden.
Oh, hello? Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
We can hear you.
Yep.
Excellent. Sorry about that. I have an unfiltered 7% IPA. It's from a local Toronto brewery called Amsterdam. And I very much enjoy it. If you can ever find Bone Shaker where you are, if you are into IPAs, I recommend it.
All right.
Not sponsored, but good.
Yeah.
Not sponsored. No, this is just like a personal recommendation that if you enjoy IPA beverages, I recommend it. Okay. And on that note, we are all good to go.
Yep. Yeah. I think we're ready.
Well, Jason, cover your hand, damn it.
Quit looking at my hand.
Man. This has been a running gag with Jason.
Yeah.
Perfect. I'm going to play an extremely overpowered Nomad Outpost Tapped, and I will pass the turn.
Okay. I will draw for turn.
Jason, hand again.
Stop it. How? Where? What? Oh, barely. Alright, I'm gonna play a Prismatic Vista. Yeah. I'm gonna crack it. It'll give me a basic land. Which will be a snow-covered mountain. Shuffle once. I'm gonna tap the snow-covered mountain for Wheel of Fortune. No, I'm just kidding. Forgotten Cave. I'm gonna cycle Forgotten Cave and draw a card. And pass.
All right. Draw. Temple of Deceit. Scry one. Leave that on the bottom. And then pass.
Untap. Upkeep, draw for turn. I will play a Battlefield Forge. I'll tap these both for a Boros Signet, and I will pass the turn.
Oh shit! All right, draw for turn. I'm gonna play a mountain. Snow-covered island. That's what I'm gonna play. I'm gonna tap it to cycle Lonely Sandbar. Draw a card. Pass.
Draw of turn. Cave of Coilus. Wishclaw Talisman.
Ayy.
Go ahead.
Untap. Upkeep. Draw for turn. I will tap a Battlefield Forge for colorless and the Boros Signet. To play a Rakdos Signet. And then...
This guy.
I don't think I... Let me see. I tap that for that. No, unfortunately, I do not have a turn. So I shall pass.
Draw.
Maybe.
I will play... Sulfur Falls, enters tapped unless you control an island or a mountain. I happen to control both. I will tap three for Spell Seeker. When it enters the battlefield, you may search your library for an instant or sorcery card with converted mana cost 2 or less. Reveal it, put it into your hand.
I am no longer in blue. I cannot do anything about this. Oh, right. I should actually... my apologies. Should change my commander. There we go.
The question is... What do I want? None of that. So two or less. Mystical Tutor. And pass.
Alright, I'll untap.
Tutor for a tutor.
Turn. That's the way. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cards. Activating Wish Claw. Okay, give me arguments for why you should have the Wish Claw.
Because I invited you.
Nah, Jason, you had it last turn.
I didn't get to use it, though.
I'll tutor for a card.
And that has two counters on it?
Yep. So if you want, you can just give it to Jason after.
You could. You should.
Maybe. We'll see. I don't know. We'll see what his case looks like.
Let's see.
And Wish Claw is for any card, right?
Yep.
And it doesn't cost me life or anything. I just tap it. It loses a counter. I give it to whoever and I get what I want.
You pay one life. You have to pay one mana. Generic.
Oh, one mana? Okay, cool. Okay. I'll pull that up on the side so I can remember what it does.
Let's see.
Man, Spell Table is such a sweet tool.
Yep. I love
it. Yeah.
I wish it let you do more than four players, but I get it.
We'll take this card. And do a couple of quick ones. Play a land for turn and pass.
Ready. We'll untap. Keep draw. I will lose one. Tap Wish Claw Talisman, and I'll be nice. I'll give it to Jason.
Oh, yay!
And in case you haven't noticed, I haven't made a land draw in quite a while, so that's what I'm using it for. I'm sure, just as it was intended, right? To just go get a land.
Yeah.
I have used a Vampiric Tutor for land before, so I feel you.
There we go. Gives me an excuse to get my plateau out.
Hell yeah.
Now I can fetch. Fools.
Yeah.
You've cheated all of us. We didn't even notice.
Alrighty. Well, I'll work on shuffling after, because I certainly won't be drawing any more cards, but just to fast track my turn, I will play... What to play.
A vampire, perhaps?
Yeah, it's but the question is which one? I think I'll do this one. Alright. I will play I'll play these two, and then I'll tap a Rakdos Signet so I can play a Taurian Mauler. It's a changeling. And whenever an opponent casts a spell, I may put a +1/+1 counter on Taurian Mauler.
Nice.
And then, because of Edgar's Eminence trigger, I will bring in a 1/1 vampire, and I will pass the turn.
Okay. Tap. Draw. Play a land. I'm going to tap two. To wizard cycle, so I'm going to cycle step through and discard this card, search your library for a wizard card, reveal it, put it into your hand, and then shuffle. I'm gonna go get me a wizard. Where are you at, wizard? Harmonic Prodigy. It is a human wizard. Has prowess. Whenever you cast a non-creature spell, this creature gets +1/+1 until end of turn. But if an ability of a shaman or another wizard you control triggers, that ability triggers an additional time. Okay.
And how do you spell that that first word?
Harmonic.
Oh, a harmonic. Harmonic Prodigy?
Yeah.
Excellent. Okay. Yeah.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Damn. So I can't actually use the tutor on this turn, or I'll have too many cards in my hand. And I don't have a fucking Dragon's Approach. What bullshit is that?
You only have those three that you showed us.
Yes. And my Dragon's, I don't even have enough to do it in this. Yeah. So I suppose I'll pass there.
What's up? Draw. Play an Arcane Sanctum. Let's see here. Do I want to be cheeky? No, not yet. I'll tap for free and bring out my commander, Sephiris.
No responses.
Nor I.
And pass.
Alrighty. Untap, upkeep.
Don't forget to give your changeling a counter.
Oh, you are very right. Oof. I have my dice in an inconvenient location.
As they should be.
Okay. So, I will play... This is not really too much happening right now. So, I will play a... one... and then I'll get these to tap each other so I can get three mana. And I will play Herald's Horn. When it enters the battlefield, I choose a creature type, vampires. Creature spells of the chosen type are one colorless mana less to cast. At the beginning of your upkeep, look at the top card of your library. If it's a creature card of the chosen type, I may reveal it and put it into my hand.
Nice.
And I will pass the turn. Right. And I will put... got to remind myself about that upkeep trigger.
Oh, before the new turn, sorry, I will tap my island for Mystical Tutor.
I will get a counter.
I will search for an instant or sorcery of my liking. Nothing's where I want it to be. In a shocking twist, I will get intuition.
Well, look at that.
This is cheating.
Judge!
I will put intuition on the top of my library. I will untap for turn. I will draw for turn. Hey! Look at that.
I can't believe you've done this.
I will play Scalding Tarn as my land for turn, and then I'm going to pay a life sacrifice it and go get an island or a mountain. Mayhaps I'll get both. And I will, with steam vents. And I'll pay two to shock it in. I'm gonna pay three to bring out my commander.
And right.
Two more for Harmonic Prodigy.
Fucking hell.
So that is a bunch of counters you just got from me, though. Two.
You're not wrong. So two, yeah, counters, two.
But yeah.
So Taurian Mauler is currently a 6/6.
Damn.
And but it doesn't have any special things attached to him. He's just a 6/6.
Just a big old 6/6 boy. I'm passing there.
Just a big old changeling bull boy.
Drove a turn. Hey, land.
I gotta remember that I got that talisman too.
So let's see here. Jason, how big is your commander?
2/2.
Beautiful. So, one black, I'm gonna cast Bone Shard and I'm gonna target your Mauler. As an additional cost, I'm gonna discard Elish Norn.
Oh shit.
A creature hits my graveyard, triggering Sephiroth.
And what does your card do? Does it destroy a creature?
Destroy target creature or planeswalker.
So you targeted my commander?
No, I targeted the Mauler.
The Taurian Mauler.
Oh.
Yeah. So that.
So, I'm gonna enter the Lost Mine of Phandelver. First room, Scry 1.
Delete. Alright. Put that on the bottom. I've got it up here now. So you're cave entrance, Scry 1. Okay, cool.
Yeah. And Dance of the Dead, targeting Elish Norn. Elish comes in tapped.
What does Dance of the Dead do?
It's a reanimation spell. It gets +1/+1, and
I'm going to Fierce Guardianship it.
Alright, I could have guessed. So we'll just have to use the next reanimation spell.
Well, got rid of one.
I'm just kidding with you.
Oh.
Let's see here.
I wouldn't be surprised in a reanimator deck, right? Oh, so
yeah. Thank you so much.
Yeah. I got a decent board state, and that would have wiped the whole board state. So I was like,
Except for your prodigy.
True. And she is good.
Let's see. I got a pass there.
Alrighty. On my upkeep, I will look at the top card of my library. If it is a creature card of the chosen type, I may reveal it, but it is not. So untap, put it in my hand. Okay. I will play Voldaren Estate as my land for turn. There's a bunch of writing on it. If I tap it and pay one life, I add one mana of any color. I can only spend this mana to cast vampire spells. I can also just tap it, and it's colorless. Or I can pay five and tap it and I create a blood token. But this ability costs one less to activate for every vampire that I control.
Sweet.
I will go let's see, I'll tap Battlefield let's untap that. I'll tap Battlefield Forge for a colorless. So I can tap Rakdos Signet. I'll tap Nomad Outpost for a black. So I got two black and a colorless. And I'll do two more. And I will play Anawan the Rune Sage. It's a 5-mana 4/3, and then at the beginning of my upkeep, each player sacrifices a non-vampire creature.
Oh, damn.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, actually, oh, shoot, and my mistake, it is one less to cast because of Herald's Horn, so I will untap that. Alrighty, and so I will put a vampire token because of Edgar's Eminence trigger. And, I'd say, yeah, I'm going to, pass the turn. And on your upkeep, Anawan trigger.
No, it's on your upkeep.
Oh, it's on my upkeep. Oh, you are correct. Correct. Oh, that's a lot less. More punishing than I thought it was going to be. All right, whatever. I guess it's fine.
I guess, yeah.
I thought it was going to be much worse.
Okay. Play an island. Alrighty,
so yeah.
I'll tap one for the talisman to go get me a card. And then I think the talisman just dies, right?
No. Yes. You give it to someone. Yeah.
Oh, but it has no more counters, so...
It has no counter, so you just give it to someone and they control it.
You can have it back.
Sweet. One more devotion.
Do you want devotion?
No.
No Nykthos in the deck? Or Cabal Coffers?
Nope. But I should put them in.
Alright. So I got my card. You guys ready for some shenanigans?
No.
Let's see it.
Okay. I'm gonna tap four for Teferi's Puzzle Box.
Oh no.
At the beginning of each player's draw step, that player puts the cards. Oh shit. This fucked me too. Okay, I gotta rethink this. Yeah. Hold on. That was stupid of me. I should have waited. Well. Ha! I thought I had something, and I realized I just fucked myself. The card I tutored for will go great with this, but I'm going to have to fucking put it on the bottom of my library. So... I'm going to back up.
Are you having a Narset?
No.
It was not. It was not knowledge pool, probably. Just locks us completely out of the game.
So, you know, I'm not going to play that, and you're going to pretend like you saw nothing.
Alright.
And
but here's the knowledge pool.
Yeah. Let's see, what do you guys got on the board? What damage you got on the board here? You got your commander. You got...
I have six.
Any flyers?
Currently, I do not.
Damn, alright. I'm gonna roll the dice here, boys. I'm going to drop a Narset! Parter of Veils down!
Bloody knew it.
Uh-huh. Each opponent can't draw more than one card each turn. For -2, I can look at the top four cards of my library. Reveal a non-creature, non-land card from among them and put it into your hand. Put the rest on the bottom of your library in any order. Okay. And that's all I can do.
Alright, untap. Draw. Well, attempt to slash the ranks. Destroy all creatures and planeswalkers except the commander. God
damn it. Alright.
That's how you do it. That's how you do it.
Yep. Yeah, that happens. Except commanders, you said?
Except commanders. Everything else dies.
Okay.
Then I'm swinging at you, Jason. 2/3.
I'll take 2.
And then I will pass.
Alrighty. Untap. Upkeep. Herald's Horn. Trigger. Look at the top card of my library. It is not a vampire. I'll put it into my hand. That's my draw step. Okay. I will play one of the new cards I recently received earlier this week. An Unclaimed Territory, but from the Warhammer 40K set. It's when you play a land, it enters the battlefield. Choose a creature type. I'll choose Vampire. I can tap it to add colorless or tap it. Add one mana of any color. Spend this mana only to cast Vampires. Let's see. So, well, now that I'm pretty much board wiped, I have to start again. I will play...
It was for the best.
Yeah, yeah. I see. I see how it... I see
if,
why.
If Teferi's Puzzle Box got out... That would have sucked.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I understand. Okay, so... How much mana do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... Alright, I will play... Tap that for a black, this for a colorless, so I can tap that for a black and a red. I will use the two black, because I have a reduced cost on creatures, to play a Vampire Nighthawk. Ooh. It's a 2/3 with flying, death touch, and lifelink. Play a vampire off the Eminence trigger, and... I am also, so I have a red that's left over from this Rakdos Signet. I will tap Unclaimed Territory for black and a Plateau for red to play a Stormkirk Captain. It has first strike and other vampires I control get +1/+1 and have first strike. I forgot about the reduction cost again. I needed a black. I didn't need a red for that. Okay. So all of these are +1/+1s. And
wait, wouldn't you still need a? Why wouldn't you need a red for it?
Because the red that floating. I had.
Oh,
had
okay.
One red floating from the Rakdos Signet.
Got it.
All those have that. Nothing has haste. Everything has summoning sickness. I will pass the turn.
Well, my plans are foiled, so let's see what else I got going on here. I'll play a land. And, I'll tap 3 for intuition. And I'll search my library for 3 cards and reveal them.
This
wonder
card.
What cards?
Let me tell you. This is going to be board wipe tribal, I swear to God.
So I'll go ahead and get these 3 dragons approaches. And Jimmy, you can choose this time. Which one can I keep?
Let's see. I'm going to choose the middle one because it requires you doing the most amount of work to get it.
Fair my enough. Man.
Fair enough. Okay.
Because the other two choices, you could easily just scoop them up, and it's super easy for you. But
yeah, don't make it.
The
easy
middle one requires me. Effort.
All right. I see. Okay, so I cast an instant spell, so homie gets a +1/+1 till the end of turn. So here's a question.
Yep.
This says if I copy or cast an instant or sorcery that causes a triggered ability of a permanent, it doubles. So would it double itself? So would I get 2+1 counters?
Can you put up your commander again so I can read it?
Yeah. Oh, sorry, I didn't realize it wasn't up. Because that just seems odd, or, I don't know, too good. It should be up.
Let's
Whenever you cast a copy of an instant or sorcery spell, it gets +1/+1 until end of turn. If you're casting or copying an instant or sorcery that causes a triggered ability of a permanent you control the trigger. Yeah, no, it would, because your commander is a permanent you control.
Yeah, that's what I thought, but I was like, okay.
No, that's exactly how it works. Yeah, you're supposed to pop off with this and like maybe try and like kill a player on like one turn.
Right. Okay, so he's a 4/4. Then I'm going to tap 3 for my other dragon's approach and deal 3 damage to both of you.
Ouch.
And that'll make him a 6/6. And I'm going to come back at Jonathan.
I'll take 6.
Yeah.
Ouch.
6 commanders, sir.
Yep.
And I'll pass there.
Up, come on.
I feel like I can see this commander being good for like a storm deck. Play a bunch of shit, make it huge, and then take someone out in one turn.
Yeah. Let's see.
Man, my card draw's offline.
I'm gonna move to end step. In my end step, I'm gonna cast Vanish into Memory on your commander, Jason.
What does that do?
It exiles it, and then I draw cards equal to its power, and then it comes back at the beginning of my next end step, and then I discard equal to his toughness.
So the power is currently, so you would draw 6 cards.
This is still my, so he doesn't keep counters, right?
Or no, it's only until the end of turn, so it's back to a 2/2.
Yeah.
Oh, so I draw 2. Okay.
Okay.
Return that card to the battlefield under its owner's control. If you do, discard cards equal to its toughness. Okay, so on his turn, you have to discard 2 cards on his upkeep?
No, at the beginning of my next upkeep. So it will go all the way around until my next upkeep.
Cool. Okay. I've never seen that card before. I was just trying to understand how it works. Yeah, me
neither. So I won't get it back till the end of your next turn.
Or you can just put it in the command zone. Either way, I get to draw.
Yeah, but then I gotta pay 2 more. I don't necessarily need it on my next turn, so yeah, whatever. Okay.
Right. I'll draw 2.
Just for the record, to give away what I have in my hand, if I did deflecting spot on that, it wouldn't allow me to draw cards, right? You would still get a draw. I would just change the target.
Yeah, I would still draw.
So, whatever. You can have 2 cards. Yeah. Not that I have deflecting spot in my hand, but you know.
And then I'll pass.
Okay. You didn't want to clap back at me?
That's my my job.
Come on, Jimmy. Remember, right? Yeah.
I have some hungry boys, and you just demonstrated how quickly and dangerous your commander can be. So, I appreciate that. I thank you for that information. I will untap, go to upkeep. Upkeep trigger on Herald's Horn. It is not a vampire creature. I will put this card into my hand and we will attempt to go big bucks, no whammies with a colorless for red black. Tap this for Mardu. I will tap this for colorless so I can get 2 mana off that, and I will attempt to play Edgar Markov.
Yep.
Alrighty, I will move to combat. I will swing with everything. All vampires have first strike, Edgar gets a +1/+1 counter off of Stormkirk Captain, and then when Edgar attacks, all vampires get +1/+1. So it's 1, 2. Alrighty, so these are all 2. So, yeah, everything has first strike. Vampire Nighthawk has flying and death touch and lifelink. I will, let's see. We'll swing 4 in the air at Jason. I will swing 3 on the ground at Jason, and then 3, 6 at Jonathan, and Edgar Markov is also gonna go towards Jonathan. So
these 3. What's my total?
You are at 6-6-4-4. I'm sorry, 6-6-3-3-3-3. 9. So, they all have first strike.
Right, so I'll take 10.
And what's my total?
And your total is 4-7, and then I will gain 4 life off of Vampire Nighthawk.
All right. Brutes.
And creatures turning sideways. I will pass the turn.
All right, I'm tapped. My commander is gone for the time being. Well, I got nothing else really to do, so fuck it. Fairy's Puzzle Box.
Bow, 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 bow.
And that's it. So, at each player's draw step, that player puts the cards in their hands on the bottom of their library in any order, then draws that many cards, starting with Jonathan.
Alright, so draw phase, trigger, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 cards to the bottom.
So that was the beginning of your draw phase. So I think...
Yeah, but it specifies you draw the card first.
Does it? At the beginning of each player's draw step, that player puts the cards in their hand. Where does it specify?
I think it's a reminder text that had lost.
Oh, I don't have the reminder text. I believe you. I trust you.
Let's see. Because that's the way it works. Yeah.
Sorry. Continue. Yeah.
So that's the way it works with Narset, because you draw your card first, then you put all to the bottom. Otherwise, you will always get at least 1 card.
Makes sense. Yeah. Okay. I trust you. I've never played the card yet, so it's first time. Yeah.
Yeah. So
plus on top of it, at the beginning of each player's draw step, at the beginning of your draw step, that is what triggers you drawing a card. And then once you draw a card, you can move to end your draw step and move into main phase.
Got it. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Cool.
Let's see here. Does nothing. Tap for 4. Cost a Auric Lore Mage. I can tap him, search my library for a card, put it into my graveyard, and if it's an instant and sorcery, he gets a +1/+1 counter. And then cost... Let's see here. Should I cost him?
If we don't deal with those vampires, I think it's over real soon.
Yeah, I'm gonna cast my Blood Artist, and moving to end step, trigger, you get your stuff back, and I discard 2 cards.
Alright.
Discarding 2 lands. And pass the turn.
Alrighty. Untap. Upkeep. Herald Horns trigger. It is a vampire. It is a vampire of the Dire Moon. And I will put that into my hand, and then I will draw for turn. Oops, yeah. Untapping requires untapping.
Did you do the Teferi puzzle?
I did not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cards in my hand to the bottom of my library. Alrighty, what have we got? Okay, I will play. That's what I got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 colorless for a cryptic gateway. Cryptic gateway is an artifact. I tap 2 untapped creatures I control. I may put a creature card from my hand into play that shares a creature type with each creature tapped this way.
Bam.
Alrighty. So, I will... What will I do? Okay, for 1 black mana, I will play Knight of the Ebon Legion. Let's see if I can put it in a place where you guys can click on it. Maybe that might work. For 2 colorless and a black, Knight of the Ebon Legion gets +3/+3 and gains death touch until end of turn. At the beginning of my end step, if a player lost 4 or more life this turn, put a +1/+1 counter on Knight of the Ebon Legion. So I will do that. I will move to combat. I will tap Edgar. Is that all vampires or just...
All.
Each vampire I control. Yeah, it's all of them, regardless if they're attacking or not. Okay. Oh, and when I played Ebon Legion, a vampire token comes in. Put the artifacts here. Okay, so everything gets a +1/+1 counter on it. I will swing, so Edgar is a 6/6. I will swing that at Jason. These vampires, that's a 3. Oh, and that's only a 2. Okay, so Edgar is at Jason. These 2 have summoning sickness. These 2 4/4 first strikes, I will send at Jonathan. I will send 5 in the air at Jason. And another 4 at Jonathan.
So I'm taking 11?
Yeah, that's 11 with 6 commander damage. And Jonathan is taking 12. And everything has 1/4 strike. 1/4/4? Cool.
Yeah. So he dies 2 separate triggers. I will drain you for 1.
Okay.
So let's see here. I'll first 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'll drain you for 1. Then Steffers triggers. I move to the next room. I create a treasure.
Okay.
Yeah. Those are my triggers.
Alrighty, and then I will gain 4 life, or sorry, 5 life off of Vampire Nighthawk. And that is my turn. At my end step, Knight of the Ebon triggers, and it will get a +1/+1 counter. And that is the end of my turn.
Draw, then put these on the bottom of my library, and draw 4. Man, I don't think this deck is working, so I'm not going to play it much anymore. Every game I've played is just a dud. So I will tap 3 for Frantic Search, draw 2 cards, then discard 2 cards, untap up to 3 lands. So draw 2. God.
And isn't your commander getting triggers off of this?
Yeah. So it has 2 counters on it right now. So it's a 4/4. I should have done that differently. Okay, so I get to untap 3 lands. Hooray. And then I'll tap 4 for Archmage Emetris, Human Wizard. Has Magecraft. Whenever you cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, draw a card.
That value.
Yeah, well, I don't know if I have another round in this.
Did you Teferi?
I did.
Or is that only for us?
No, it's for me too.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, I'll tap 3 for Dragon's Approach. You each take 3 damage. And that goes in my graveyard. I will draw 2 cards because this is going to trigger an additional time because of my commander. Fucking all right.
Wish I still had that bull out.
A 6/6. Fucking can't send him anywhere. Jonathan, I hope you got some answers, my friend. Pass.
Untap. Draw. Trigger. 3 cards. 1, 2, and 3. See, first one, second one, third one. I'll play an Elas. Some stupid name. He's a Death Toucher. Yeah, I can't pronounce this. Yes, he's a 2/2 Death Touch. Whenever another creature enters the battlefield under my control, I gain a life. And whenever a creature I control dies, each opponent loses 1 life. So, let's see. Well, tap for 3 and cost a Gift of Immortality on my Sephiroth. I will activate Auric Lore Mage. I search for a card and put it into my grave.
Yep.
Let's see here. We will get. We get a Cataclysmic Gearhulk into the grave, triggering Sephiroth. Jimmy, I will drain you for 1.
Okay.
Well, that's something, my friend. Yeah.
Jason, you don't possibly have a thing to kill one of my creatures, right?
Dude, I got nothing.
Alright, I will...
Yeah.
Let's see here. Play a land and pass the turn.
Ugh.
Quick question. How do you put your name in the brackets next to your screen name?
Oh, I didn't even know you could do that.
It's in like settings.
Okay, I'll check it out after, but I just noticed you had that now and I'm like, oh, that would be probably helpful if I did that.
Right.
Okay, at your end step, I'm gonna tap two untapped vampires and trigger Cryptic Gateway.
Yeah.
I'll put a vampire creature from my hand onto the battlefield. It doesn't trigger Edgar because I'm not casting it. I'm just putting it onto the battlefield. I want to play a Florian. There we go. That means you can click on it, hopefully. Florian Voldaren Scion. He's got first strike 3/3. At the beginning of my post-combat main phase, look at the top X cards of your library, where X is the total amount of life your opponents lost this turn. Exile one of those cards and put the rest on the bottom of your library in a random order. I may play the exiled card this turn.
All right.
Alrighty, so I will untap. Upkeep with let's see. I will put that on the top of my library. I will draw that card for turn. Teferi's Puzzle Box is still out, correct?
Right.
Yep.
Alrighty, so I will put four cards on the bottom of my library and draw four. Alrighty. Let's move to main phase. Okay. I will play a swamp for turn. Hooey. I will play one, two, three, four, and I'll play an Aroas, God of Victory. It's an indestructible enchantment, and as long as my devotion to red and white is less than 7, Aronis is not a creature. Creatures I control can't be blocked except by 2 or more creatures, so all my creatures have menace, and prevent all damage that would be dealt to attacking creatures that I control.
Well, this was fun!
I will move to attacks.
Yeah.
Jonathan, what are your two creatures?
I have a 2/2 and a 2/3.
A 2/2 and a 2/3. Okay. I will swing my board. Alrighty, so Edgar triggers, giving everything a +1/+1.
Who are you swinging what with?
All my creatures have menace, so yeah. I will swing Edgar at you, Jonathan.
Yeah.
Also, this Florian, which is a 4/4. This vampire token, which is a 3/3. And Knight of the Ebon Legion, which is a 4/5. I believe that's lethal. And then I'll swing the rest at Jason, which is a 5/5. 7-8 in the air with lifelink and 5/5s. Everything has a first strike.
What's the total damage?
So 10, total damage
17
for you is 25. Sorry. 5, 10, 15, 22 in the air for Jason, and 7, 10, 14, 18.
Can I get the individual ones?
Yep. So
the 1, 7.
Yeah, Edgar Markov is a 7, 7. The vampire token is a 3/3. The legendary one is a 4/4. And Knight of the Ebon Legion is a 4/5.
Okay. So if I double block Markov, I will only take 11 then.
You have to double block him because he has menace.
Yeah, so I double block Markov. And then we have 4 plus 4 plus 3. So 8, 9, 10, 11.
4 plus 4 plus 3. Yeah, you have 11.
Yeah, so I go down to 1.
You have 1 life. Yes.
Okay. Death triggers.
Okay.
So Zephyrus will see the other creature die. So it will have a trigger there. Gift of Immortality will trigger. He will see another creature trigger. So we'll start by draining you for 1.
Okay.
Gift of Immortality will then bring back Zephyrus.
Okay.
Zephyrus, other trigger, go to 4. Draw a card. And complete the dungeon, triggering Zephyrus. I return a creature card from my grave to the battlefield.
Okay.
I'll return Cataclysmic Gearhulk.
Okay.
We choose a creature, an artifact, and a planes... Here. Choose an artifact, a creature, an enchantment, a planeswalker from among the permanents we control, then sacrifices the rest.
Oh, brutal. All right, so sorry. I choose, a creature.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, and what were the other ones?
A creature, an enchantment, an artifact, and a planeswalker.
Creature, enchantment.
And well, I wish I knew you were doing that before.
An artifact. Okay. So, creature, enchantment, an artifact. Already. And then sacrifice the rest?
Yeah. So I'll choose my Gearhulk as a creature and artifact and Zephyrus as a creature.
Alrighty, I will choose Edgar Markov as a creature, Cryptic Gateway as my artifact, and Eroas as my enchantment.
Alright.
And this Herald's Horn also goes away.
Yep.
Alrighty. And, I guess this is still, you did that on, those are all triggers that happen,
yeah,
right?
Those are all triggers that happens in combat.
Okay.
So I still would have died, right?
Yeah.
Okay, just, all right, good. Because I was like, I already shuffled.
Oh, no, I would have stopped you otherwise.
Okay.
Alrighty, then I guess I shall pass turn.
Alright, untap.
Oh, come on, Jonathan, come back.
I believe you said you had 4. I think you said you had 4 life.
4.
I think you said you did something with your commander, and then you said go up to 4.
No. This one gave me 1 life, and that's it.
Oh, okay. Okay, no problem.
Yeah. So, land for turn. Well, then. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to exile your Edgar.
Okay. I will put him into the command zone.
Let's see. Move to combat.
Yep.
Gear Hulk and Sephiroth at face.
All right. How much is that?
It's 4, 5, 6.
Okay.
And pass the turn.
Alrighty.
Come on, Jonathan.
Untap. Upkeep. I will draw for turn.
Take him with 2 life.
I am going to...
those mana rocks should be sacrificed by Gear Hulk.
Oh, you're right. You're right. Okay. Okay, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I will play then. So Edgar's a 6. He's got... I will play... I'll play an Edgar Charmed Groom, play a vampire, it comes in with a +1 because of Edgar Charmed Groom.
Yeah.
And I will pass the turn.
Alright, untap, draw. Alright, that's something. Oh yeah, forgot end step. Where did I put it? Oh, put it as a reminder here. End step, this would have attached back to my Sephiroth.
Yep.
So, let's see here, your Edgar is currently a 4-4.
Correct, yeah.
I'll pass the turn.
Untap, upkeep, draw for turn. I'll play a Smoldering Marsh.
Yep.
It enters, tap lets it control 2 or more basic lands, which I actually do not. So it enters the battlefield tapped. I will... swing. Let's see. Your Gear Hulk is what's the Gear Hulk?
It's a 4-5.
It's a 4-5. Okay. I will play a Chromatic Lantern.
Alright.
And I will pass the turn.
Draw. Let's see here. 4, 5, and 6. Noxious Gear Hulk. His ETB is I get to destroy another target creature, so I'll destroy Edgar. I will gain life equal to his toughness.
Alrighty, he's a 4-4. Edgar flips, becomes a legendary artifact. At the beginning of my upkeep, I create a 1-1 white and black vampire creature token with lifelink, and I put a bloodline commander on Edgar. If there are 3 or more bloodline counters, I remove these counters and transform Edgar.
Yep. Then I will swing Gear Hulk at you for 4.
I will take.
I will then pass the turn.
Alrighty. On my upkeep, I will play this. We'll just make it a zombie, and just so we can differentiate between which one is which. Zombie will enter the battlefield. Untap, upkeep. Draw for turn.
Don't forget the bloodline counter.
Oh, you are correct. I will play... do I... Oh, I don't think I still have enough. That's a 6. 5, 6. No,
yeah,
that
is
enough.
Enough.
Yeah, okay. I will play Edgar Markov. And it... comes into the battlefield. Yeah.
Yep.
Edgar comes in. He's a 5-5. Oh, you have 6 life.
He's a 4-4.
And your Gee-Hulk is a 4. Is a 4-5.
4-5 and 5-4.
Unfortunate. Alrighty. I will play a land for turn.
Alright.
No. I played the smoldering. I will.
No, that was last turn.
That was last turn? Okay, yeah. Thank you. And I will pass the turn.
Untap. Draw. I will play High Markets. And let's see. Pass the turn.
So
who can draw the answer first?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. This is such a nail. I'm such a nail biter.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Alright, let's try and see if this works. I will... That... That goes up to that. This creates another one of these. This one has Summoning Sickness. I will tap 2 and play Throne of the God Pharaoh.
Oof.
See if it's the one. And I will swing. Does this work? Okay, if I attack everything gets a +1/+1. Everything has menace. I think. I don't know. I think this wins. All right, so everything gets a +1.
Hmm. So everything has menace too.
Yeah. And they don't take damage during combat.
Hmm. Can I do anything? Hmm.
This one gets a counter if you know that summoning sickness. Oops.
Yeah, I'm dead. I just have an island.
Oh, okay. Good game, dude. Good game.
Oh, shit. Next card, animate dead. Oh, was one away.
Oh, those were some good games, guys.
Yeah.
They were. Oh, man. 2 for 2. When we get that rematch, I'm coming for you, man.
I can't wait. I can't wait to see what kind of is it bullshit you build.
Well, this deck needs work for sure. That's 4 games now I've done with it, and it's just like does not pop off like it's supposed to. I don't know. Yeah, it just.
I have a Discord group that I play Magic with on Spelltable pretty regularly, and I can add you.
Yeah, that'd be
into
awesome.
That group. But I have played three times with this Edgar Markov deck, and the last time I played with it, I drew 12 lands in a row.
Wow.
Oof.
Yeah, exactly. And I was like, I promise you, there are vampires in this vampire deck. I promise you, there is.
I have a dinosaur deck, and like a fool, my opening hand was all lands. I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm sure I'll draw something. I kid you not. Every card I drew in that game besides one was lands, and
unreal.
The card I did draw that wasn't a land was the dinosaur that has Enrage that says when it's dealt damage, you may search for a basic land. I was like, oh my fucking god. So, it happens, for sure. Well, gents, Jimmy, don't leave just yet. We're going to do a little send off real quick. But Jonathan, yeah, sure. As always, thank you, my man.
Thanks a lot for having me.
Yeah, I'll see you at the next one.
Yeah, that was
one,
awesome
sure.
playing with you, dude.
Yep.
Yeah.
If you're on Discord, I'll get your contact off of Jason. We'll definitely play some more games.
Yeah,
for sure.
If you drop that link in our group, because he's in my Discord, so he's definitely on it.
Right on.
Yeah.
But that'd be sick. All right.
Yeah. 100%. Yeah, you dudes are good dudes, and I know the group that I play with is they'd appreciate you guys having around. There's at least like a game every single night that somebody's asking, like, hey, does anybody want to join? So it's awesome. Good times.
Awesome. Cool. All right.
Yep.
Jonathan, see you around, my friend.
Yep. See you all around.
It was nice meeting you, dude.
Nice meeting you too, Jimmy.